because I think this is one of the problems that Finnish language in universities are usually taught to support like daily conversations, but not like job related things.
These students have lots of potential, linguistic potential as well. It's just that often they hear that their Finnish language skills are a problem.
Back then, you really, when you went to the workplace, you were the only dark-skinned person there, only international student who stepped foot on that ward, and it was very cold reception.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to another episode of Talenbus Podcasts. And today we're going to talk about SaSu project, which is a project aimed to help international nursing students in Finland. And more about it will be told by our guests today, Riikka and Judith. Please welcome them.
Thank you.
Thank you. And thank you for inviting us.
Yeah. How are you doing?
Good.
Yeah.
Looking forward to the summer holidays, I think, like everybody else.
Yeah, I'm waiting for sun all these days, but it doesn't seem like it's coming
not this year.
Yeah, well, maybe when the holiday starts.
Yeah, so it's a pleasure to be here with you and to talk about this project. So first I want to point out about this things that are talked about among nursing a lot. I have seen quite a while a lot of articles about nursing challenges in Finland. So the main thing is that many international students are struggling with job seeking in Finland. But as I heard that international nursing students actually are facing with a bit other problem that they're employed, but they can't get the qualification level that they should be assigned to due to lack of Finnish language. But is it so in reality? I want to ask from you, what do you think about these issues right now?
Yes, I think it's actually changed quite rapidly. That couple of years back, it was, as you first said, that our students, our graduates were struggling to find a job altogether. But now recently, maybe 1-2 years, the problem has more been about finding a job they are qualified for. Mm. So many of our graduates still work as lähihoitaja, like practical nurse, even a couple of hours after their graduation, even though they have bachelor's degree level in nursing. So they would be qualified to do sairaanhoitaja work. And the most common explanation is that the employers feel that their Finnish skills are not what is required from more independent, work style, and what is needed from the nurses, so that they can work independently with patients and families and in teams of multi-professional healthcare specialists.
Yeah, what do you think?
It's like Riikka said, a few years ago, it was the opposite problem, was that we had students graduating, but they couldn't find work. Like, it's the trend, I think, with all international students from all fields. But nowadays, due to the nursing shortage in Finland, we see that there are jobs available, but the contracts given to the qualified nurses from an international background are usually lower than that of a sairaanhoitaja. So they're usually given lähihoitaja contracts instead of sairaanhoitaja contracts. And usually language is given as the reason as to why they're not sort of upgraded to a nursing contract usually. So it's a very interesting, there's nursing shortage, but there are qualified nurses available, but they're not actually given the opportunity to work as nurses.
Yeah. And this is also a geographical issue, because many of our graduates end up working in the capital area, where the language requirements or Finnish language requirements are significantly lower or more practical, how to put it. So many of the people who can't get nurses contract in this area actually do get it in the Helsinki and capital area. So there are also lots of geographical differences, maybe cultural differences here.
Yeah,
I think the feedback is that in Helsinki especially, they're very open-minded and more sort of embracing multicultural sort of workforce there, and the language is not considered a barrier but rather a richness, and they actually encourage nurses to come, or international nurses to come to Helsinki area and sort of find employment there. So they're much more open-minded about what it means to work in a multicultural environment rather than in Keski-Suomi. I think maybe we're still a bit behind sometimes in understanding. It's not always a negative if someone doesn't speak perfect Finnish. It's actually, you know, they have other qualities as well that they bring to the table before their language is considered good enough, if it ever is. But
And maybe also that in capital area, people are already more used to hearing Finnish spoken in different ways. Mm-hmm. So they don't expect only like native kind of Finnish.
Yeah.
But other styles are accepted. And also maybe, like you said, these students have lots of potential, linguistic potential as well. It's just that often they hear that their Finnish language skills are a problem. Mm-hmm. But actually, they have huge linguistic potential. How many languages they speak? We have more than 20 different nationalities, and our students speak more than 20 different languages. Mm-hmm. So actually, that's a huge potential that has not really been used or valued. And maybe in capital area, they also understand this better, that patients come from different linguistic backgrounds. So actually, our students will be able to talk with these patients as well that don't.
It's so interesting when you actually talk to the students, and some of them speak four or five languages, and Finnish is their fifth or sixth. It's amazing because the rest of us are struggling to get by with two languages.
I completely agree with you that Helsinki seems like for many, maybe not just like international, but to all students, like more kind of a nice place to start working, maybe because salary is a bit higher. And also, as you said, that's it's more kind of diverse in culture, and maybe it's more kind of open to accept people from other cultures rather than in central Finland, because this is not like the only issue in nursing, but I think it's also an issue in other degree programs that many students are actually either leaving Finland or leaving to bigger cities. So yeah, this is kind of a thing. And about the languages, that many international students speak like more than one and two languages, I think it's also true. And they should like keep in mind that like Finnish is not like their second or third language, but like fourth or fifth.
And not all patients speak Finnish either, so it's actually a resource. Also, one thing we have heard from our students, and based on our own experience, social networks is also one thing, that it's easier to go to work in a place where you are not the first kind of a pioneer, first non-native Finnish nurse. So if you have a choice, like there is in Helsinki area, that you go to a place that you know that the people who graduated from last year groups, the year before, they are working there. So they have their people from their own networks already there. They know who they're going to work with. They know that in this place, I'm not the first one who doesn't speak native Finnish. So also that. And well, that's one of the things we are trying to also encourage in SaSu project, that when you get the first one in, then they will attract more people to join this workplace if the feedback is positive.
Well, you already slightly mentioned SaSu project. So my next question would be, what is SaSu project? What is the aim of this project that you are participating in and you're doing?
Yes, SaSu, so that would be sairaanhoitajan integroituminen suomalaiselle urapolulle, or nurses integration into Finnish working life as a nurse. So our main goal is to build a model how to support our international students in their professional Finnish language learning during their studies and also after their graduation in cooperation with healthcare employers. So the new thing here is that we are working in cooperation with the employers, and also the new thing is that this continues after graduation, which we are really happy to be able to offer to our students this chance that they can continue with us even after they've graduated. They can still contact us, we can still go to their workplaces, they can still have these language workshops and whatever they want our support for. And also for employers, that it might lower the step for them if it's the first non-native Finnish speaker they are hiring, that they know that the school is kind of backing up, that they can also discuss with us, and we are there with our newly graduated nurse or student. So they are not so alone finding their ways, but we can continue to support what they need, what they feel. So it's also personalized, that what does this student and what does this workplace.
Mm-hmm. Is this a temporary project or is it going to be too ongoing further?
This is a 2-year project. So we started in September 21. We are finishing at the end of this August. Mm-hmm. And EU funded, so ASR, European Social Fund, is funding this. And so it's not permanent, unfortunately.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But we've already got lots of questions and wishes that how can we continue this? Mm-hmm. So there's a very clear need for this kind of support and project. Of course, this model we are trying to build should help even after the project, but probably more time and more practical kind of tools are still mm-hmm. needed after project. Within this model, the we've got kind of those two things. So both supporting students to learn professional Finnish language more than they would during their studies and Finnish courses otherwise. Mm-hmm. But then also to help in integration. So it's not just the language, it's integration. Of course, language is a big part of that, but also social and cultural integration that they would feel as part of the work staff in their work units. Because also one of the things we've noticed is that many of our graduates change jobs quite often. Mm. 2 months here, 3 months there, maybe just 1 3-week list here. And that's not benefit for anybody. No. So also helping them to actually find their place, to feel that this is my place, these are my colleagues, I belong here, to stay in that place. And that also is one of the SaSu aims, that we help in this integration and also work with the workplaces. So it's not just the student who has to do all the work, learn the language, learn the culture, integrate, but also how employer, mentor, staff support in that. How can they support in the language learning process? How can they support this integration, take this student or newly graduated nurse as part of their mm-hmm. team? So also, and of course, we talk a lot about cultural issues in like general level as well. What does it mean to come to a new country, new culture, mm-hmm. especially healthcare is very culturally related. So what kind of things can be really different compared to where our student came from, how to talk about these things. So both linguistically, but then culturally, this integration is our aim in the project and how to support in that.
This sounds like a really, really nice project. I think it's kind of similar also in the mission as Talent Boost mm-hmm. to help international students as much as they can with the budget that they can to share in this project. And I wonder what are the results so far, because you said that now like students wish to have it like more further going, and I wonder like if there are these kind of cases, is there a chance that it can be kind of still ongoing? So I want to hear like from you, maybe Judith, about the results. What do students say? Did it really help them, and etc.?
The feedback was very positive. I think the students and the graduates that I interviewed were always wishing that it was actually started long before the closer to their graduation, because the support that they got from the SaSu team, the SaSu program itself, was so immense in terms of language workshops. And also very large part of the positive feedback was when the teachers, SaSu team, went to the workplace. So they are engaged in the negotiating for contracts or introducing the workplace to the student, vice versa. So they go and visit as a team to these new workplaces, and the student felt so welcomed and heard and seen, because I think it's the lack of belonging that usually is the biggest problem for the international students or international nurses in this case, that they don't stay so long, they don't feel welcome, so they don't stay, mm-hmm. and they also ultimately leave Keski Suomi. But the SaSu program was the whole purpose was that they are not alone. Mm-hmm. You need to understand that in the nursing context, learning the language is not enough. You have to, it's the human aspect behind it in the practicalities of our day-to-day workings. When they leave to work in a new place, they might speak Finnish, but when we have to do sort of nursing duty, sort of doctor's rounds and answering the phone and certain nursing duties, the language becomes more complex. And SaSu, one of the workshops, some of the workshops we have actually addresses these exact problems, like what actually practicalities do we have on the workplace that you face every day that you find overwhelming. So we deal with those things, how to receive a new patient. So we have these workshops for that, language workshops that have been run by the SaSu project, and scenarios of you know, how to deal with a dying patient. What are the, and also like Riikka said, the cultural differences are enormous. And it's very interesting to see the feedback from the students, how they didn't realize just how different their understanding of, for example, how Finnish people deal with death, or how they deal with certain aspects of Finnish culture or the elderly. It's very different. And if you don't understand these cultural differences, it makes it's potential for conflict in the workplace, or for misunderstandings rather in the workplace, because our cultures are so different and language is not enough for you to integrate into a workplace. It's understanding, reading between the lines and how we deal with a human to human basis. It's very different, because in the nursing context, it's not language. It's, we deal with life and death, and very stressful and acute and traumatizing situations sometimes. So it's not enough to speak the language, and also medical terminology is such a huge part of nursing, and international students have to deal with a lot of that. The normal language courses don't really address that. But SaSu has the practicalities in the workshop that we deal with medical terms, but also turning it into more sort of, what's the term Sara always uses? Everyday language. So it's how people really speak on the work, the lingua and the phrasit, the phrases that they use there, that it's not taught in language classes, but it's more in the medical setting. So, yeah.
This is, I think, such a nice, important value of this project, that that you teach the Finnish language according to the job, like market level, and you provide this terminology in Finnish language, because I think this is one of the problems, that Finnish language in universities are usually taught to support like daily conversations, but not like job related things. And I think this is also quite a problem in like business, international business degree. And there are like, I think, some talkings about like, should it be changed in the future, that we should more emphasize on a job-related courses in Finnish. So I think this is such a great thing that SaSu does. And how many students overall have you had since the beginning?
We started with a group of 10 graduating students. Some of them, for personal reasons, left Jyväskylä, not the project, but Jyväskylä as well. So we ended up with 6 in the graduating group last year, but then the next year's group was full 10. And this spring, interestingly, lots of younger students, like Judith was saying, that there were comments that they wish they could have had a chance to participate earlier in the studies. So we had lots of requests from younger students, and they want to come too. They've heard about the project, they want to participate too, and we got the permission with the changing of the project plan, and we got the permission from Ely to let the younger students participate as well. So then we actually have 30 new students who started this spring. Of course, they won't have time to graduate during the project, but we hope to help them in their practices and future jobs. They are also doing summer jobs, so to help them. What you said about the language thing, that was a very good point. And actually also what Judith mentioned, Sara. So we have a Finnish language teacher in the project team as well, and we are really happy to have her, because she's been working with the nursing students and nursing teachers for years. So even though she's teaching general Finnish, she knows our context and our professional vocabulary quite well. So we are really happy to have her as part of the team. And also I would really like to highlight the point that in our project team, more than half of our project team also has their personal experience of learning Finnish language and integrating into Finnish working life and nursing healthcare system. So that's one interesting thing also that I found, that our teachers who run these workshops to teach Finnish professional language are not native speakers, but they have also learned the language themselves. So I think this is also something quite interesting and new.
Yeah.
That they're continuously sharing their own experience and using their own background here.
And it's quite nice because this, what the difference is from the SaSu project and why the students' feedback is the way it is back when I was a student and I graduated, I had the same experience, but then we didn't have any sort of luxury of these sort of projects. And it really is, it's such a blessing because back then you really, when you went to the workplace, you were the only dark-skinned person there, only international student who stepped foot on that ward, and it was very cold reception. And it was very difficult to integrate, very, very difficult. But nowadays it's really lovely that we have so many international nurses and also students all on the same ward, and also in much more international, the medical staff, the doctors and all that sort of other medical professionals in the workplace. And the students, although we still face the problem with the language, but now we have much more better ways of preparing for that. So we understand what mistakes were made in the past or what we can improve on. And that's what the SaSu project actually does. The workshops are actually very practical. And I was actually talking to some of the other teachers, like, if only we had this when I was a student, it would save me years of headache, because it was so difficult. So little too late. And it was so difficult. And now it's really great that we understand that it's not about language, it's about medical terminology and understanding what our job is on the ward when we go on doctor's rounds. I don't need to know how to buy bread when I go on doctor's rounds. I need to know how to make these orders. Doctors are going to call that other, you know, the warden and transfer the patient, and very, very practical things. And that's very good that we understand this.
And I think it's also really, I don't know, you got the results, you got the feedback, but I think it's also important that our students are able to see you, Suleiman, when being fuzzy last kind of role models in the project.
Yeah, I think it's also because when, and like I said, it makes me sound very old when I say this, but it's when I was a student, there really was no one actually who looked like me on the way. I think there was one in Keskussairaala back then, one or two maybe international students, nurses rather, and it was very, very difficult, but I like it when I see now that there's so many of them out there from all over the world, and that's what we love about the international nursing degree. It's so mixed and it's so international. It's really, really lovely. The energy is really good. And it makes a difference, because when you feel welcomed, you see somebody who looks like you, sounds like you, and tells you it's okay. You don't need to be perfect with your language. You don't need to be perfect in the things you do, because it's all a learning process. You'll get there in the end, rather than to be faced every day with, I'm sorry, you don't understand what you're doing. You know, you can't be involved in this process or in that, you know, procedure, because that's really what used to happen. Your language was not enough, so they would push you to the side, and that was it. You weren't able to participate in many things in the Finnish context or Finnish workplace because your language was not sufficient. But now with the international mentors and understanding of international students' needs and different ways they learn, we know that we can take them on board and they learn differently. And the language comes automatically along the way. It's not something that we have to, you know, pound into their heads for them to understand. It's because it's complex. In the nursing degree, we learn the nursing profession, and then on top of that, we have to learn language.
Yeah.
The Finnish nursing students, they just need to learn the profession, so they have a much more smoother transition. But the international students, they have to learn the practicalities of the job, medications, you know, everything.
Culture.
And culture on top of everything else. And it's very difficult.
Yeah.
But when they see others who have done it and can give them sort of tips, okay, this is a better way of doing it. Like the workshops, we've just kind of like cut the middleman, and we understand what they actually need to function as a nurse on the job. So we just cut out the unnecessary stuff. And I think Sara and Wenbing have done such a really lovely job with it.
Absolutely. Yeah. And also the mentors and employers at the units that participate in SaSu. So we have the elderly care units, home care units who are participating in the project. And we have excellent mentors and employers who are willing to give some time, give some extra opportunities, like plan the duties, that you don't have to do everything yet. as you graduate, but plan a little what are the duties that don't require the highest language, Finnish language mm-hmm. levels. So a little planning, little time, and then you've got an excellent, motivated, well-integrated nurse. There's working for you, hopefully staying there. So also what we feel that this is like the number one thing, that the attitude, the willingness is there, that mm-hmm. that you see the possibilities, you are willing to give the chance, you're willing to give that little time and mm-hmm. an opportunity. So also that mentoring and employer support are really, really important.
I can completely imagine all of this struggle in terminology, because there were some times where I needed to visit a doctor and I was like, how can I explain it? Because I don't know how I call it in English. So I had like to Google it first, like mm-hmm. in English, and then translate it to Finnish. I think it's really hard. And before you mentioned that it was challenging being a first person to kind of open these doors for others, and it was hard to integrate to this working culture while being also international person there. I think we mentioned it with Suleiman in our previous podcast, and I like to see that you're like so dedicated to talk about this project, and like I can see it in your eyes that you're like wanting to tell more and more and more. And I think I personally have seen a lot of international nursing students in YAMK who are really like open and willing to like be part of this culture and integrate in it. And of course there are so many like things that we need to go through as an international people to be able like to be included and seen equally. So I really love what you are doing, and the purpose of this project is amazing, and I hope that this semester you will have like even more successful cases. And yeah, like you're telling it, and I'm just thinking also about Telenbus, that it's also a temporary project and that one day it will end, unfortunately. And but still I hope that students will learn from what they already have, and it's nice that you have this kind of role models who they can kind of look at and do the same things, but having also their own individual path. So it's nice that you have like a great support of each other. And as I said, like I have seen many international nursing students who are so dedicated and so like hardworking. And I see that like maybe as an example, I would say Rabera. I don't know if you know her.
We certainly do.
Yeah, but she is an amazing. She told like when we met that how she managed to find her first job, I think. And she said that I was just visiting and asking people straightly, directly, and and it was like, wow. So you actually have to think like out of the box and not like limit yourself in the way that, oh, like it's not possible. It is possible. Mm-hmm. And it's nice. So I think yeah. that's what I wanted to say in conclusion.
Yeah. Our students are so highly motivated. As we discussed, they do like triple job.
Yeah.
Profession, learning the language, learning the culture. And as you mentioned, Raperos is an excellent example of how to show this motivation, and also about something that we feel is typical for many international students, that even they might be still developing their Finnish language skills, mm-hmm. but how they express this nursing professional attitude, the warmth, the caring, mm-hmm. all this yeah. very important in communication with the patients. Not all patients can speak either because of their illness or disabilities, and so on. So non-verbal communication is so important as well. And I highly believe that our international students are so skilled in non-verbal communication, yeah. reading the signs, observating things.
Mm-hmm. They come from so much more social cultures and more observing. Kind of like, yeah. So much more warm cultures and more more comfortable with physical touch and more open socially, but I think one of the we're talking about like employment, because in the nursing workplace or nursing environment. Usually you get jobs when you go for practice and they see mm-hmm. you, they like you, then you have connection. If they need some part-time worker, then they call you up. So your connection and network is created when you go on practice, and that's the way most nursing students get jobs. Mm-hmm. But the problem some of our international students have is because they are so shy and they are so withdrawn because of the language or lack of language there, or rather, on when they are at practice, that they don't actually bring out their full mm-hmm. selves or their best selves. And I think one of the best things we can always do and encourage them to do is do your best, even if you don't speak the language, but you can show your potential mm-hmm. in other ways. And when they've done that, they actually do get called back for a cake or gigs here and there, and they get employment at the end.
Yeah, and again, if they're given the chance. Yes.
Exactly. So, but they also have to remember to be brave enough to be themselves, because although some places are negative towards international students without perfect Finnish, but there are a lot of other places when they see your potential and they see as a person, as a nurse, mm-hmm. well, of course, then they kind of think differently, that, okay, if we give them a chance, the language comes automatically. So why not?
Yeah.
So it's kind of a two-way street.
Yeah, definitely. And I think this is should be the highlight of today's discussion, that be brave, be open, and you'll get there, yeah. I think. And thanks again for joining today. I'm really grateful for that. And I hope you will have a nice rest of the day.
Thank you.
Thank you for having us. And you too.
Bye, guys. Bye.